Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Verma and I am a mother of 4-year-old Khushi. We were the happiest parents in the world when Khushi was born. She was born as a healthy baby, weighing about 3 kgs at birth. But before we were discharged from the hospital, the pediatrician suggested that we test Khushi for a thyroid test as a part of routine procedure. We were confused. We thought thyroid only affects adults. However, when we read on the internet, we realized that in all developed countries around the world, all newborn babies are screened for thyroid disorder. The pediatrician took a small blood sample from the heel and placed it on a special type of filter paper for testing. The next day, we had the test results. Our pediatrician told us that the report was abnormal and we should consult a specialist called an endocrinologist who can help further clarify the issue. We were scared and we met an endocrinologist the next day. The endocrinologist was very calm and answered all our queries. A second blood sample was taken to confirm the diagnosis. They also asked for an ultrasound and a special type of test called a thyroid scan. As suspected, Khushi had a congenital hypothyroidism due to thyroid agenesis. These complex terms basically mean that Khushi did not have a functioning thyroid gland and hence could not produce thyroid hormones. But she is perfectly normal, doctor, we told our endocrinologist. The endocrinologist said that congenital hypothyroidism does not lead to any symptoms for a few weeks after birth. This is because the thyroid hormones from the mother obtained by the baby would mask the symptoms. Since Khushi did not have a thyroid gland, after a couple of weeks, her thyroid hormones would start dropping and she may start showing symptoms of absent thyroid hormones. What happens if we don't treat this? We asked. The doctor said that congenital hypothyroidism is the most common cause of preventable mental retardation worldwide, and timely treatment can easily prevent her from developing serious mental and physical handicap. So what kind of treatment does she need? We asked. The doctor said, we need to give her a small thyroid pill, almost the same kind which adults use. However, it is to be crushed and given to the child daily. Additionally, the child would need thyroid tests done regularly to adjust the dose of thyroid tablets. We started Khushi on the thyroid tablets. She is 4 years old now, and believe me, she is the smartest girl in her class. She is a normal, happy child. We consider ourselves lucky. Just a few drops of blood tested at the right time and just a small tablet to be taken every day allowed our little girl to live a perfectly normal life. The doctor told us that the tablet needs to be taken lifelong in case of Khushi since she does not have a thyroid gland. The doctor warned us not to stop the tablet or give any other form of alternative therapy. Congenital hypothyroidism is simple to treat with a simple tablet, and there is no role of any complementary alternative therapy in this treatment.
Thank you.